For years, I mean, that's just kind of the traditional way of teaching math. Unfortunately, it's still that way. You lecture, you show some examples, and then you give them some time to work.
Champion High School calculus teacher Bryce Mertz says he always taught math the same way.
I'm going to give credit to Wendy. A year ago, she's the one who brainstormed this idea, threw it at me over the summer. I was very apprehensive about this idea.
That is until Teacher of the Year and Physics Teacher Wendy Zamzo approached him with the idea to merge their math and science classes.
And the more that I got into the calculus-based Physics C course, the more I saw the integration of physics and calculus and how they go hand in hand.
The calculus and physics students now work together on projects that apply real-life problems. For example, the one they're working on today, calculating how long and what it will take to refill a backyard pool.
It gives us some perspective on how we'll be applying physics in the real world, and it gives us experience working with other students who maybe don't have the same background that we do, so we can learn to work with a group of students that has a diverse knowledge.
Champion senior and future UT engineering student Michaela Tate says the physics students account for the different physical variables, while the math students use the correct calculations.
When we approached this problem, we were kind of showing the calculus students how they could apply their knowledge.
And especially like if you're an engineer major, which is like half of these people in here, like this is definitely stuff they're gonna be doing.
And for senior Elise Baroni, who will be a psychology major at Baylor and plans to attend medical school, it's a way to get her feet wet.
And I've never taken a physics class, so it's really like helpful because I know I'm gonna need physics in college. So being able to get introduced to like these physics topics now is better so that in college I'm a little bit more prepared.
Mr. Mertz said the students took to it immediately.
Very excited, fully engaged, loved the challenge, loved the idea of trying to figure this thing out. No, they took to it very, very well.
But the success of this collaboration is also hinged on one important thing.
This is one of the most exciting parts because this space was built for collaboration. Right here is not just a wall, it is a door that opens up into our lab space.
The classroom is designed to be turned into three different labs, similar to the way a lot of colleges are now making their engineering labs.
We want to try to mirror what they're going to experience at the university level, but ultimately in the workforce.
And that's because industry leaders are now asking that students have collaboration, problem solving, and communication skills.
Think about all the things they're going to have to consider in the real world when they actually get jobs.
Right. And be able to work in teams, work together.
Getting the students to engage, because in this space we have a lot more freedom to move around and obviously apply our knowledge like you see us doing today.
Overall, I think it's like a really good idea, and I know both of the teachers, Mr. Mertz and Ms. Samso, are really like happy with it, and I think they're really like passionate about getting these like collaborations done. And I think the students, like all of us, are benefiting from it.
Mr. Mertz says the collaboration has exceeded his expectations.
It's proven to be an excellent idea. We're hoping that in the future we can enhance this and improve it. The administration's been amazing with this idea. They've been so supportive, giving us the space to do this in. So no, it's been a wonderful experience.
They advocate for other teachers to try this collaboration and give them this advice.
You have to be willing to take risks. You have to be willing to put yourself out there and try something new, and maybe it doesn't work, maybe it does.
Your showcase of innovation for May, Champion High School.